Hello everyone, I'm Himani. I work here at Playford as a customer service officer. Painting is my hobby. I do Warli painting. Now, what is Warli painting? Warli painting is originated in India by an indigenous group called Warli. That's why it's called Warli painting. Now, how do you know it is Warli painting? Mainly, it has two colors, one white and other is maroon. Now, where do these colors come from? So white is basically a grounded rice, and they make liquidy paste of it, and they draw figures with that, and they use earthen colors as a background. They celebrate lots of festivals, and on those occasions they usually draw those paintings. So I'm trying to do wall hanging for you today. If you're sitting at home with kids and if you have holidays and if you're bored, it's the best activity to do. Kids enjoy it a lot. I always do it with my son. So let's begin. So for this, I have got plain piece of white paper, as you can see. Then I have got a ribbon. I've got a glue stick here, a punching machine. Then I have got eraser. One brown pencil, one normal pencil. I have cut some strips of printed paper here, but if you don't have that at home, you can always draw the border by yourself. And I have got scissors here. So let's begin by punching at first. So we'll make two big holes here. We are going to put the ribbon and like this. So cut as much as you can. You can make a bigger wall hanging as well if you like. I'm making just a sample for you. There we go. So we'll have two little knots here. Oopsie. So we have got two paintings at the background here, where you can see a little village, and there is a lady, I think she's in her hut with her pots and pans cooking. So you can go crazy with your ideas, and with the basic two colors you can do anything what you like, based on triangular and circular figures. So here I have got that ready for you. So you can just hang like this on the wall. I'm going to put these papers as a background on this white paper. So I'm just going to put some glue on it. Warli people will always have some sort of a background a border to their paintings. They love to draw borders. I'm just going a bit, because I have got this printed paper available, I'm going with that. But feel free to do the borders as you like. So I'm going to stick all of those and make a nice border for our wall hanging. and hopefully that will look nice at the end. I'm just going to keep this aside with that so that it doesn't come when we actually paint our figures. What is going on the top? Just like this. And there is the last one. So that's going on this side. So the border is almost ready. So it looks like this. Now we are going to draw figures in the middle. So let's begin with the person who is holding instrument in his hand. So I'm doing it straight with the brown pencil, but you feel free to draw that with normal pencil so that you can erase if you like. Now this instrument is called tarpa. It's a particular instrument that they make out of bamboo and wooden branches. So this person is actually playing this little instrument here. Now, we'll draw another person. Now this is a man. How would you know the difference between man and woman? For them, it's very simple. The man wear hair like this, and women usually have bun on their heads. So I will shortly show you how to draw a woman. Now this lady has got bun on her head, that's why she is a woman, as simple as that. She is holding a beautiful lamp in her hand. And now let's draw a man holding hand. This man is playing. Now, let's draw another woman. this lady is holding another instrument. And we draw another man here. With their postures, you can make that they are playing band and dancing basically. Okay, so our wall hanging is complete here. So let's have a closer look. There you go. So that's ready. Now feel free to paint these figures in the middle. That's how usually it is. As you can see at the back, they're all white figures and they're all painted. So I have actually drawn some figures to show you how it's drawn, and then feel free to paint it. Thank you.